Welcome back. Some very good news from the state of California as to who can get a vaccination shot. As of April 1st, anybody over 50. And then on April 15th, it's open swim. Anybody who wants one can get one. With us is Colleen Shalby. She's with the Los Angeles Times. She's been covering the COVID-19 crisis and now is their point person on coverage of the vaccination rollout. So let me ask you, though, despite this good news, we're getting the sense, though, we got it from the lead world health reporter from the New York Times, a columnist with your paper, who pretty much said anybody who can get the shot should get it, regardless of your pecking order, because it's all about getting vaccinations and trying to get herd immunity as opposed to people lining up in the right spot. Do I have that right?
Yeah, we've seen a handful of counties earlier this week that already expanded eligibility beyond the state guidance, you know, lowering the age threshold, expanding to people with medical conditions outside of what the state has already presented. And, you know, just recently, yesterday, we learned that Kaiser Permanente in Southern California has also expanded eligibility for some essential workers. So that does seem to be playing out more and more. As I'm saying this, I'm realizing that Long Beach also just announced yesterday that they were expanding eligibility. So I think as we get closer to April 1st, we're going to see restrictions loosen kind of at a county by county level.
So there has been a concern that neighborhoods of color have been among those that have been reluctant to sign up for the vaccine. But the New York Times and others are saying, actually, that's not the problem. The problem are red counties, the counties that voted for President Trump, particularly of those voters, conservative men. They're the group more than any other who are not lining up for this vaccine. Is there any evidence of that?
I think anecdotally, we have been hearing stories of people crossing lines into some of these counties where maybe there's an extra vaccine, there's surplus. I learned from one county earlier this week that decided to lower the threshold to 45. It's a Northern California rural county, Tulumi, and they said that vaccine hesitancy did play into that. They didn't say that there was one particular group that they were looking at, but I think that it's possible that, you know, several people there that, you know, might lean towards more conservatively are not getting the vaccine. So we are hearing this more and more. I think the data that's really being collected at the state and county levels are regarding people in marginalized communities, but this certainly seems to be something that is playing out.
Is there evidence that people who've gotten the first shot, that in and of itself is what is responsible for the dramatic reduction in transmission?
So it's still too soon for health experts to say if people who are vaccinated, you know, are not asymptomatic carriers of the vaccine, it's still possible that they could still spread it. So it's really unclear if it's driving transmission down in that regards. But overall, I mean, we are seeing lower cases, we're seeing lower hospitalization rates, and it could be due to a variety of reasons. I will say, though, in LA County, the transmission rate has increased just slightly over the past week. It was just announced. And again, it's really unclear if that's due to asymptomatic carrier spread, you know, via vaccinated people, if it's due to just, you know, kind of newfound activity happening. So it's still too soon, unfortunately, to say, but it does seem like that is a strong possibility.
Right. There is a big disconnect, though. We're seeing all sorts of positive news coming out of Sacramento and some of the counties. But at the same time, we're seeing spikes in COVID-19 transmission in Michigan and some other states. It's going up. They have real problems overseas in France and Italy, huge problems in Brazil. I get the impression that the effort now is to get as many vaccinations out as possible before these variants start to take root.
Yeah, definitely. I think that that is part of the reason why we are kind of headed towards this free-for-all mode where, you know, it seems like the priority now is just getting shots in arms. You know, it's not as much right now as like who is in line, but just getting people into line. And I do think that with these variants that are causing concern, that is becoming a much bigger need. And especially, as you mentioned, as transmission is kind of rising in other parts of the state, you know, getting as many people vaccinated and protected as soon as possible is definitely the key to this fight.
Colleen Shalby of the Los Angeles Times covering the vaccine rollout for that newspaper. Out of curiosity, when are you going to get your vaccination?
I don't know. I'm hoping sooner than later. I will be looking on my computer right on April 15th if I learn that journalists are, eligible before that. I will certainly be looking, but I don't know at this point. I'm trying to be patient, but I definitely would like to get one as soon as possible.
Certainly all of us share that thought. Thank you very much, Colleen Shalby from the Los Angeles Times.